Hi everybody. If you watched my previous video, you'll know that about a month ago I got hold of the new Nanoleaf canvas panels. It's taken me a while to get them installed. I was really anxious to do it, but we went away for a few days. Christmas was coming, just didn't have that opportunity. But now I've done it, they're up, and they look great. In the video today, I'm going to show you how to get your layout right, how to get them in the right position on the wall, and how to get them actually attached to the wall. And then we'll have a quick look at the Nanoleaf software and what these panels can do. This is the space in my tech room that I'm going to fill with the Nano lights. To set up your lights, you're going to need three things: phone, spirit level, and a tape measure. The first thing to do before installing your panels is to sketch a rough plan of where you want them to go, so you can measure the spaces and work out with the borders just how much space you've got to create your design. I wanted a 20cm border around the top and the sides of my design, and room below to fit a desk in the future. So this means I have to fit my design into a space about 90cm wide, 60cm tall, plus some extra on the right hand side which will go over the shelves. I can now start playing with the canvas tiles and try to make a pattern that I'm happy with. I spent around 20 to 30 minutes moving them around until I found a design that I liked. I then measured to make sure it was approximately 90cm wide and not higher than 60cm. And then took the measurements of where the bottom control panel tile would be in relation to the wall, simply by adding 20cm border to the actual measurement. The next step is to measure and mark the wall where the bottom right hand corner of the panel is going to go using the measurements we've just worked out. And then use a spirit level to draw a vertical line which ensures the first panel is straight. Finally, don't forget to take a picture of your layout with your phone. Okay, it's getting close to the exciting time now where we can mount them on the wall. On the back of each nano panel, there's four places for stickers, but they advise you to use three. I'm guessing on this one, and either of these two. Basically, just peel the sticker off, stick it onto here, and then you peel the other side off. Push it against the wall for 30 seconds and that's it, it should be stuck. The first thing you want to do is the control panel, because this one's got to be at the bottom of the design, or it doesn't have to be at the bottom, but it has to be it's the first one you connect. So that's important to get this one on first. So I'm going to sticker all these up now and get them onto the wall. Okay, the first panel is installed. It's fairly easy, a little bit nerve-wracking, but it's quite easy to do. And the next thing you want to do once the first panel is installed is to get the power onto it. It takes a few seconds to boot up and now it's working fine. We'll install the app now from the iOS store and get it paired with the lights, and then we can start adding more and more panels. So we'll now look at the app that you get to see how we can customise the Nanoleaf panels. This one's on iOS, but you can also get it on the Google Play Store. So this is the main dashboard, and these are the solid colours. As you can see now, that's on the warm white. We can press reading light or daylight, so it alters it to a slightly bluer colour. And then the next tab along is colour. So here we can have a colour burst, and this will just phase through different colour patterns, as you can see, the blue, then the should go on to the green next, and then the red, etc. And there's falling whites, flames, forest, inner peace, one called Nemo. Okay. Northern Lights. Oh, I like that one. That one's really nice and romantic. Now, all these come with the app. You can make your own custom ones up at the top here. You've got different colour pickers. You've got where you can create your own scenes. But let's just go on to the next section. This is rhythm. So these next ones are going to be interactive. So we'll put on fireworks. And then when we talk, as you can see, they interact. So I guess the louder you talk, the more they'll interact. Let's try that on Meteor Shower now. So again, similar idea. So this is really great if you want to have some music, you want to have some fun, to have these going. We'll just cycle through these. So that's Meteor Shower. We've got Paint Splatter here. Hello. Next one's called Pulse Pop Beats. We just need to talk, and that one's a bit more subtle, quite like that one. Rhythmic Northern Lights, so lots of different colours again, all cloud inspired. Soundbar, I guess this one is one of those meters that you get, so yeah, you can see it goes up, the louder the noise. Yeah, that's really nice. And we've finally got streaking notes. The next section along here is interactive, and it says get ready to have some fun with your lights. It's asking us to download new ones, so we actually have to discover those. Okay, so that was dashboard. I'm just going to the discover. So these are things you can download to give you more different moods. These are just the basic colour ones. The beach one looks nice. Let's just download that one. So I'm downloading that one now, and that one should appear here, I guess. Yeah, okay. So we go to the store, any that we like. We can, Mint one looks nice as well. We'll download that one. Mint's a good name for it. Go to the dashboard, and there it is. Let's discover something that's a little bit more rhythm. Quite a lot of choice here. Now let's go for Rave. Let's download that one. Go back to my dashboard and this is Rave. It's very colourful and it's again voice reactive. And then finally we've got interactive. So these are actually games that you can play. So we can play Simon, we can play Pac-Man, we can play Game of Life. Let's try Simon. Let's download it. So the instructions are place your hand on the panel for 3 seconds for the game to start. So I'm going to go over now and do that. Let's just go back to the colour mode now, the basic colour modes. We're just going to switch on inner piece at the moment. These are also touch sensitive, so any that we want to change, we can sweep over them and change them. So that's the Nanoleaf canvas panels. I really, really like them. Lots of really good things about them. I really like the way they look. I really love the colours. I love the interaction you can have with them with music or the game side of it. Really great fun. I think my only real negative with them is the cost of them. I bought the basic set of starter pack, which was 9 panels, plus the 2 extension packs, which come with a further 4 panels, so 17 panels in total. And that was sort of about £300 to £400. So they're not a cheap thing, but they will last for years and years and give you lots of pleasure. So it's whatever you want to do, really. But as far as the actual product goes, I think they're great. Really like them, really recommend them. Hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it helps you decide whether or not you want to buy them. And if you do buy them, how to set them up. Thanks very much for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. See you soon.